This is the Higher 2015 paper 2, and this is question 5. Circle C1 has equation x squared plus y squared plus 6x plus 10y plus 9 equals 0, and the centre of circle C2 is 9, 11. Circle C1 and C2 touch externally. Determine the radius of C2. Okay. First of all, C1 has equation x squared plus y squared plus 6x plus 10y plus 9. We need to get the centre of it, okay? So again, there we have x squared plus y squared plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c gives you 0. 2g is 6, so g is 3. 2f is 10, so f is 5, and c is 9. The centre is minus g minus f, so C1 has centre minus 3 minus 5. And why does it have radius 5? Well, I've done that over here. The radius is the root of g squared plus f squared take away c. 9 at 25 take 9 gives you the root of 25, which is 5. Now, C2 has centre at 9, 11. If we just go back to the original diagram, I'll show you this key won't mind. There we have minus 3, minus 5, up to 9, 11. What's the distance there? And I've written in the radius of circle C1. So we want the distance from that coordinate to that coordinate there. Okay, back we go. Right, so we want the distance. So the distance from the x-coordinate of C2 to the x-coordinate of C1 is 9 take minus 3, that's 12. The distance from the y-coordinate of C2 to the y-coordinate of C1 is 11 take minus 5, that's 16. Square them, calculator out, gives you 400. So the distance between the centres of C1 and C2 is 20. And with C1 having a radius of 5, that leaves a radius of 15 for circle C2. Okay. Now part B says, a third circle C3 is drawn such that both C1 and C2 touch C3 internally. That means that they touch this big circle from the inside of it. They're both inside it. So here's my diagram to represent what's happening there. There's C1, there's C2, and here's this bigger circle, C3. Now, just to show you, yeah, obviously asked for the equation of C3. So here it is here. We want the equation of this bigger circle here. Now, with C1 having a radius of 5 and C2 having a radius of 15, I can draw a line going right through C1, C2 to, as a diameter of this circle C3. And each radius is 5, so that's 5, that's 5, 5, 10, 15, remember that's the radius of C2, and another 5, 10, 15 there. So that's the diameter of C3. The centre of C3 is of course in the middle. So how many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 jumps of 5. So the centre of C3 is 1, 2, 3, 4. It's the fourth bit one in. So that's it there. We want to know what that coordinate is there. Well, it's the coordinate that cuts the line going from C1 to C2 in the ratio 1, 2, 3 to 1. We want that point there. Cut C1 to C2 in the ratio 3 to 1. Okay, so here we have there. So what's the vector from C1 to C2? Minus 3 to 9 is 12. Minus 5 to 11 is 16. That's 4 lots of 3, 4. So C1 to the midpoint of the middle of C3 is 3 lots of 3, 4, which is 9, 12. So that means that C3 has to be 6, 7. Why? Well, if you start off at minus 3 and you go along 9, you're going to end up at 6. And if you start off at minus 5 and you need to go along 12 to get to the midpoint of circle C3, you're going to end up at 7. So the centre of C3 is 6, 7. And as we said earlier on, it's got a radius of 20. So x minus 6 squared plus y minus 7 squared is r squared. X minus a squared plus y minus b squared is r squared. There we have it there.